I remember when I met Carl Martin. It must have been a dozen years ago. This wise old gent was gray and bent, but his eyes had a fiery glow. He was born April Fool's Day of 1906 near Big Stone Gap, VA. He could play a little fiddle and some blues guitar that he'd picked up along the way. But Jethro, once he put his hands on the mandolin, he lit up just like a Christmas tree. Along with Ted Bogan and Howard Armstrong, they were the best string band I ever did see. Now for 50-odd years, they played rent parties, roadhouses, concerts, and festivals too. At the drop of a hat, these three black cats would play you every song they knew. It was Lady Be Good and the Barnyard Dance and the Ice Cream Freezer Blues. Now they'd trot the oldest chestnuts out and make everyone sound brand new. And little white boys with their shiny guitars would follow right along at their heels. They learned all the words and they learned all the chords, but they never did learn how it feels. Now one night I asked Carl where he got the fire, and he said, "Steve, you gotta understand. You wanna be someone, you better have some fun, and you better get it while you can." He said, "You better get it while you can. You better get it while you can. If you wait too long, it'll all be gone, and you'll be sorry then. It doesn't matter if you're rich or poor, and it's the same for a woman or a man. From the cradle to the crypt is a mighty short trip, so you better get it while you can." Carl always had a way to make the good times roll when the rest of us weren't so sure. He'd just pick out the prettiest woman in the room, and then he'd sing every song to her. Now one night back east, when the gig was done, there was an all-night blowout jam. We played and we sang and we drank for hours until the sun came up again. It was blues and ballads, ragtime, Dixieland, swing, some old-time show tunes, and then Carl Martin sang some songs nobody else knew, and some I haven't heard since then. But right before dawn, he did two more songs just to separate the strong from the faint. It was a red-hot rendition of the Old Pine Tree and a double-time version of the Saints, with the mandolin behind his head. When he was done, those of us who could still breathe took off our hats to that man. Carl had played everybody under the table that night, and he said, "You better get it while you can." It was, "You better get it while you can. You better get it while you can. If you wait too long, it'll all be gone, and you'll be sorry then. It doesn't matter if you're rich or poor, and it's the same for a woman or a man. From the cradle to the crypt is a mighty short trip, so you better get it while you can." You know, Carl and his buddies never got too far. When he died, Martin didn't have a dime. He was a little behind in his payments and a little bit ahead of his time. Last week, some so-called musicians stayed up real late and burned one down. The liquor kept coming, so we kept strumming till a minute or two before dawn. There were those who stayed and those who faded, but soon I was left all alone. Now, I don't believe in ghosts, but I could swear I heard Carl Martin singing one more song. It went, "You better get it while you can. You better get it while you can. If you wait too long, it'll all be gone. You'll be sorry then. It doesn't matter if you're rich or poor, and it's the same for a woman or a man. From the cradle to the crypt is a mighty short trip, so you better get it while you can. You better get it while you can."